Now today we start with chapter number 11, Reflection of Life. Right, you have done this in each standard also. Most important thing for any object to reflect. What is necessary is light. Without light, you are not able to see any object. Like if I tell you to enter into a dark room, like you go in a theater or something, a dark theater something, and you enter inside. So for at least 5 seconds or a flash of a second or 10 seconds or 15 seconds, you become totally blind. You are not able to see anything because there is no light inside the theater there. But once the light is reflected on your eyes, once the light falls on your eyes, then that light gives you a clear picture of the objects that you are trying to see in front of you. So light is the most important medium to see any objects that are there in our surroundings. Okay, so to see all the objects in our surroundings, light is the most important medium to find out the objects that are there in our surroundings. Without light, we won't be able to see. Now, in 10th standard, you also did something like whenever light is reflected to smooth surfaces. So, smooth surfaces, if it is reflected, you get a regular reflection. Or in fact, whenever it is reflected from a smooth surface, then you have what? Yeah, regular reflection it is. And whenever the light is reflected from a rough surface, this all we have done in each standard, you have irregular reflection. So regular reflection and irregular reflection. Like we have done in this, if you have a smooth mirror, so rays of light. So whenever rays of light are coming, so the reflection is parallel to one another, this way. So the reflection goes this way. But suppose if the surface is not smooth, if it is this way, then the reflection will go, one will go here, one may go here, one may go down anyway. So this is called irregular reflection. This is called regular reflection. So this we have done in the 8th standard also, regular reflection and irregular reflection. Now in 9th standard, we are going to learn about mirrors. Mirrors, if I break it up into two parts, mirrors are of two types, plane mirrors and spherical mirrors. Plane mirrors and spherical mirrors. Again, spherical mirrors, we will do of two types of spherical mirrors. One is concave mirror and one is convex mirror. Okay, so in 9th we are going to learn all this about the mirrors. Mirrors, two types of mirrors we have usually, plane mirrors and spherical mirrors. Plane mirrors are mirrors, like if I tell you, plane mirrors are mirrors that you have at your home. That means you have aane ke samne khade rehte ho, right? When you stand in front of the mirror, so you see your image in the mirror. Whatever you are wearing, if you are wearing a blue color shirt, a red color shirt, whatever, you see it in the mirror over there, that is called a plane mirror. Plane mirror, remember, because your house's glass is broken, so you must have seen over there, in the plane mirror, the back side of the mirror, is coated. Piche ka part jo rehta mirror ka, that is coated. Okay? it is coated with a surface that is a reflecting surface of aluminium or silver. Usually aluminium से coated किया जाता है, silver बहुत महंगा चीज है. So it is coated with a surface of aluminium or silver. And on this aluminium or silver, again to protect it, a thin film is put upon, which is of lead oxide. Lead oxide. So whenever a glass breaks, this lead oxide is red in color. So whenever a glass breaks, and you see the back part of the glass, एक लाल कलर का कोटिंग दिखाई देता है, रेड कलर का. दैट रेड कलर कोटिंग इज मेड अप ऑफ लेड ऑक्साइड एंड बिलो दैट लेड ऑक्साइड अ कोटिंग इज गिविंग ऑफ सिल्वर एंड सिल्वर और एल्यूमिनियम. आइदर एल्यूमिनियम और सिल्वर कोटिंग इज गिवन. सो व्हेनेवर यू स्टैंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर यू सी योर इमेजेस डायरेक्टली इन फ्रंट ऑफ द मिरर एंड यू कैन सी योर सेल्फ वेरी प्रॉपरली. वॉट एवर यू हैव वोर्न इट, वॉट एवर क्लोज यू आर वेरिंग, you want to comb your hair or you want to dress up yourself and all, so you stand in front of a plain mirror. Plain mirrors are usually found at homes and all, that you can see it properly. Spherical mirrors are of two types, but before going to spherical mirrors, this is the later part of our topic, so before going to spherical mirrors, first we'll try to understand more about plain mirrors. Plain mirrors, suppose if I keep two plain mirrors together, matlab ek plain mirror samjho ye ek mirror hai mera, ek ye blackboard abhi tum logo ko dikhai de raha. सपोज दिस इज वन मिरर और एक मिरर अगर मैं यहाँ से और रखता हूँ, बराबर, तो मतलब एक मिरर ये है, एक मिरर ये है. व्हेन यू गो टू सम डिपार्टमेंटल स्टोर या कुछ ड्रेस खरीदने को जाते हो, कपड़ा खरीदने को जाते हो, तो व्हेन यू गो टू द ट्रायल रूम, व्हेन यू एंटर द ट्रायल रूम, तो एक कांच यहाँ पे लगा हुआ रहेगा, एक कांच यहाँ पे लगा हुआ रहेगा, एक कांच यहाँ पे लगा हुआ रहेगा. ऑल द थ्री साइड्स ऑफ ग्लासेस आर देयर एंड वन डोर इज देयर. यू एंटर इन साइड. So when you enter inside, you can see front also, right hand side also, left hand side also. So you see yourself properly after wearing the clothes and all, how you are looking and all, okay? That glasses are kept at a particular angle to form the images, okay? So these glasses are kept at a particular angle to form the images. Now to form the images or to find the images, how many images can be formed by the plane mirrors? You have a formula that is, you have a formula of 360 upon A minus 1. Now suppose if the angle of the two glasses, if the angle of the two glasses is 90 degrees, so 360 upon 90 minus 1. So 9 1s are 9 4s are. So 4 minus 1. So how many images you will get? 3 images you will get. That means 1, 2, 3. ज़्यादा करके ये ड्रेसिंग रूम्स में होता है, जो तुम शॉपिंग मॉल वगैरह में जाते हो तो वहां पे ड्रेसिंग रूम्स में 90-90 का रहता है. मतलब एक मिरर यहाँ पे रहता है, एक मिरर यहाँ पे रहता है, एक मिरर सामने रहता है. तो यू कैन सी वन इमेज ओवर योर, यू कैन सी वन इमेज ओवर योर एंड यू कैन सी वन इमेज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. So three images you can see. So it is at an angle of 90 degrees. So 90 degrees if it is, you see three images over there. Suppose if it is 120 degrees. So 12 ones are, 12 threes are, 3 minus 1. So it will give you how many images? Two images, right? It depends. Now suppose if it is 60 degrees. So 360 upon angle is 60 degrees minus 1, 6 minus 1. How many images you can see? 5 images you can see. Okay? So now this is the formula. So you have to remember this formula to find out the number of images. That is number of images formed by any two mirrors when they are kept at an angle 360 upon A minus 1.